So let's go ahead and take a look at my test code for the Q class. So it doesn't actually take a whole lot to get full coverage on the Q class. And this is a good point. We haven't tested the Q a huge amount here. It shows a little bit of the problems with especially just normal statement coverage. So let's go ahead and get started. So we start off with just a Q of size 2. We assert that it does actually get made, and then we call checkRep. We're going to be calling checkRep after every single test that we do, just as a further test. And really, any of the tests that we do that call the internals of the Q class should probably be in checkRep, because we don't necessarily want our test code to have to worry about the internals of it. We want the internal testing to be taken care of by the class itself, preferably, although you don't always get that. But after that, we check the queue starts off as empty, which it should be, and that the queue is not full, which it also should not be. And then we try to dequeue from the empty queue, and this should return none, according to the specification. Then we're going to enqueue 10 into the queue, and we should get a true result back. Enqueue returns true if you successfully enqueue something, false if it doesn't correctly enqueue for some reason or another. Then we enqueue 20, and again, it should be true. Now we check that it's empty again. It should not be empty, and we check that it's full. Since it's a queue of size 2, the full method should return true, and that's what we assert here. Now we further try to enqueue 30, but since the queue should already be full, this should return false, and we go ahead and assert that. Now we try to dequeue from that, and we should get 10 out, since this is a queue, it's a first-in, first-out data structure. Then we try to dequeue again, and we should get 20 out. And again, after each of these, we call checkRep. If I go ahead and submit this, we see that I got it right. Okay, so that's one way you could have done it. There are a number of different possibilities here, and it, like I said, it doesn't really take a huge amount of code to get full coverage of the Q class. In fact, what I did here is probably a bit much. But again, it doesn't necessarily tell us a whole lot about whether the Q class is in fact correct in any meaningful way. So great, I hope you got that right and had fun with it. I hope it also wasn't too challenging, but I hope it made you think.